Hi everyone, it's John.
And Ben.
And we're in October. Halloween is... we'll be here before you know it.
Soon.
So we are here with another Halloween toy review today. What do we got today? It looks like Monster High.
Yes, we have SKELITA CALAVERAS.
I'm glad you said that. I would have said totally wrong. And there would have been 18,000 comments. From Scaris, City of Frights.
Yes.
And you've had your eyes on this one forever.
Mm-hmm. I have. I saw this one, and you guys all know how much I love Halloween. This is a very Halloween-y doll. With the black and the orange hair, down to the skeleton body. It's perfect. I love this.
Very unique.
Mm-hmm. Yes, definitely. So I am so excited to open this up.
All right, well, let's take a look inside this box. Well, first, let's take a look at the back.
So we already have Katrine.
Yes, we do.
Mm-hmm. She's the painter, if I remember correctly. She's not on the back of this box. But it gives the little bio here. She's 15. Her parents are the Los Esqueletos. All of you that speak Spanish are going to be killing me with my pronunciation. Sorry. And her BFFs are...
Gina Fire Long
and Claudine Wolf. And her favorite food are sugar skulls.
Sugar skulls?
I bet I'd like those, too.
What if they're real skulls? Well, I don't think she'd eat real skulls. Yeah, she's, like, made out of skulls. Yeah. So I don't know if she'd eat real skulls. That'd be kind of weird. You know, like a dog... like a dog carrying a bone around.
Okay, I'm going to change the subject by opening the box.
You know, maybe that could be your new nickname. No, I could call you Sugar Skull.
Sugar Skull. I don't know
if... you don't think so?
I don't think that will.
Hey, Sugar Skull. What's for dinner?
You're such a... there you go. Okay, she comes with the stand. I'll pop that out.
The brush, comb.
Yep, for her hair.
Now, if you collect Monster High, you guys must have like...
a gazillion of these.
Yeah, you must have like boxes of these.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do with all your combs?
This is her little notebook.
It must be the family.
Yeah, must be.
Is that a skeleton dog?
Looks like it. That's pretty cute. They should have put him with her.
Yeah.
That would have been awesome.
That'd be cute, like have a little skeleton puppy.
Yeah. It's like a little diary.
I'm gonna guess her with those little spindly legs, there's no way she'd stand up on her own.
No.
She'd be like...
So here's her little suitcase on wheels.
Can you open it up? And it looks like you can actually fit stuff in there. Yeah. I bet you could fit the comb in there. No, not quite. I tried. That's pretty neat. That's a pretty cool accessory. Also doesn't stand up by itself.
No. So let's take her out of here. What do you say?
At first glance, she kind of looks like a dog.
No.
Like with the little nose.
No, that's supposed to be like nose. The hollowed out part of the skull.
Like one of those creepy Pinky Cooper dog people that we've seen.
I'm afraid of breaking her legs. I don't want to break them.
Yeah, you don't want to bend the knees too far back.
It doesn't look like they bend very well.
There's a joint in there, but
yeah.
You don't want to force it, I don't think.
So, her legs are not going to bend, because I don't want to do it without breaking her. And all of her accessories are held on with elastics here.
Oh, and her arm's, like, held into place, too. I won't touch. I'm going to stop touching the doll.
So look how tiny her little fingers are. They're so small. I feel like I'm going to break them.
So, basically, I'm not allowed to touch this doll whatsoever.
No. I mean, the joints are supposed to come apart like normal Monster High dolls. You know, just pull and they should come apart, but... no, John, you're not allowed to touch.
Aww.
So, how cool is this? Hold on a second. I gotta undress her.
Well, she's already a skull, so.
Yeah. I know, and that's what I want to show. So.
We're going to see some skeleton nudity here?
Yes.
Oh, it is literally a skeleton under there. It is
literally a skeleton. I wanted to show that. That her whole body really is a skeleton. It's not the normal body with just the skeleton arms and legs. Isn't that cool?
These fashion dolls are getting skinnier and skinnier.
Okay, I'll put her clothes back on now. But I just wanted to show the body.
That's pretty neat. They could have just cheated and like painted on a rib cage or something.
Yep.
Makes it a very, very unique doll, which is probably explains why we've had such a hard time finding it.
I've seen it like once or twice, and John didn't let me buy it.
Well, she had so many that we hadn't even opened yet.
So we're like, okay, well, we'll wait. And then once I got all caught up, we couldn't find her.
Until the other day at Walmart when they had one.
Yep, she was the only one they had.
They like had just restocked the Monster High end cap. There we go. You have to be very careful. She does not like to stand up.
No, she doesn't. Where her body really is a skeleton, it doesn't actually, these clips don't actually touch her body like they do on the other Monster High dolls. But she is so cool. I'm so happy we were able to find her. So if you like our review of Skelita Calaveras from the Scaris City of Frights Monster High collection, be sure to subscribe to our channel.
And like and comment.
Follow us on Twitter.
On Instagram.
And on Facebook.
Thanks for watching, everybody.
Bye!